Muscles are responsible for movement of our limbs and several other internal organs such as intestine and heart. So some amount of muscle tissue is present in the blood vessels, which can dilate and contract the blood vessels. Muscle tissue is made up of with elongated cells called muscle fibers. Muscle fibers consisting a protein known as contractile protein, which helps to contract and relax the muscles. When we expose to cool air, we shiver. Because of shivering, our muscles get contract and relax. Due to this, huge amount of heat liberates. So muscular system helps to generate the heat and keep our body warm also. Based on the location and function, muscles are classified into three groups. First one is voluntary and involuntary, and then cardiac muscles. Voluntary muscles are also called as skeletal muscles because most of the muscles are attached to the skeleton or the bones. The action of these muscles are voluntary, means under our control. Skeletal muscles have alternate bonds, that's what they are called as striated muscles also. The cells are long, cylindrical, multinucleated and unbranched. Next one, smooth muscle. Smooth muscle is also called as non-striated muscle because they do not have any striations. No unbranched smooth muscle, smooth muscles are unbranched and they don't have striations, and they are multinucleated and the ends are pointed ends. Then coming to the next one is cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscle is restricted to heart. It appears like voluntary and its functioning is involuntary. So these are present only in the heart. Let us compare the three kinds of muscles in a tabular form here. Skeletal muscles, they are voluntary in action and they are striated and attached to the bones, their location attached to the bones. And smooth muscles, the functioning is involuntary and they are non-striated. They are present in digestive system, blood vessels, even in the iris of the eye. Then the third group of muscle is cardiac muscle. The appearance is like voluntary and the functioning is like involuntary. And their appearance is striated and it locates only in the heart. So here we can see the three kinds of muscles. The next tissue is nervous tissue. So nervous system composed with brain and spinal cord and then nerves. Nerves form a network of projections throughout the body. So a nerve cell consisting mainly three parts, a cyton and dendrites and a long projection which is called as an axon. So here in the cyton or cell body, a huge and prominent nucleus is located and grain-like projections which are called nissl granules also present. And dendrites are several branched like projections which are arising from the cell body, helps to connect with the adjacent neuron. And here we can find a long projection which named as axon. So axon is covered with a thin sheath called myelin sheath. What is the function of myelin sheath? Myelin sheath helps as impulse insulator. It prevents the leakage of the impulses. And myelin sheath is not continuous. It leaves gaps at regular intervals which are called as nodes of Ranvier. And then axon ends with axon terminals or the nerve terminals. So these are nerve terminals help to connect with other neuron dendrites or other neurons nerve terminals. Like this, a neuron is joins with the help of dendrite or with the nerve terminals and form a continuous network where the stimulus and responses pass continuously.